Let's make a list of all the things we've talked about today, okay? In multiple dimensions, right? So, multiple dimensions means we are at the individual level, at the collective team level, and at the organization level, right? So, when we actually look into a situation, it's good to have logical levels in different ways. What are we talking about? Okay. So typically I like to look at an organization like a triangle or like a chair with three feet. Okay? This is an individual. Kind of like me. Make it simple. What's in it for me? How do I become better at it? And how I become better to face the other issues. Okay? So what you have here is you would have what we call the collective. How do we work together? How do we collaborate? How do we do this with others? And of course, you have the notion of team project, groups, work groups. So we have to be very good at this as well. And often I find out that this is where people are not being trained sufficiently. When you're alone, you can get a fair amount of control over yourself. But when you work with other people, it gets really complex. So how do we, all of these things that you brought up this morning has to do with collective. Collaboration. Right? And it gets more complicated when you have vendors. What kind of relationship do I have with them? And all of those things. So you pointed out a lot of problems. I see these are challenges, not really problems. They're almost predictable. And then you have to worry about the organization. Right? So that's some of the things you've been talking about. And a lot of what you've been talking about has to deal with change. So how do we manage change? And who's the central person in the middle that helps make decisions, organize change, make moves in there? So I think all of you have pointed out these change issues. And particularly the person that can help the whole change going on. And then there are many factors. Okay, so let's look at this. So, first thing, ideas are there, possibilities are there, solutions are there, and I have a hard time making it reality. People are too busy with their stuff, they're not listening, I can't influence them, I can't make the decision. Somehow, this could help their work, but we are a long way off with this good idea and making it real, right? So you're getting a fair amount of resistance there, or lack of interest, so you're wondering, how can you influence the organization? So one of the things is there, is as you define change, how do you create a business case? That's a skill. How you create a business case and then people are convinced. Which means how do you influence? I would say you're having some difficulty as a manager leader, creating influence, convincing people, stopping them, and asking them to shift priorities. So we started off with that. Okay. Then another issue is coming in, which is how to, very personal level, how do I balance my life? Right? And also, looks like it's a theme this week. How do we avoid burnout? You agree? Yes. This word has come up a lot. cooperate, which brings in the issue, how can we be supportive to each other? Is there enough empathy here? Are people considering this? Are people taking the human factor into consideration in all of that? How are we managing these boundaries? As an individual, what are my boundaries? When do I say no? A lot of you have been asking, can you teach me how to say no? Very popular request. That's about boundaries. So these issues of boundaries is fundamental. How do we set boundaries? How do we enforce boundaries? How do we negotiate boundaries? How do we deal with boundaries, right? So this has come up as well. Burnout, boundaries, project, boundaries. There's a lot of boundary stuff going on here. Even when you deal with agreements, those agreements are not respected. Again, there's issues of boundaries here. Okay. So some of the things that you've been saying are related to vendor relationship. And you said the quality of the work. The relationship, how do we approach it? Can we approach it differently? Also, what you're saying is there is something going on here with the interface, which is with my vendor, I'm not talking to the right person. And somebody else does the work and it's not up to my expectations. So I have to redo this work. So why are we outsourcing if I have to review everything? I'm just not getting the quality work I think I need. So there's something about interfaces and access to the right person. So there's something about how can I be good at defining change? How can I be good at balancing my life? How can I be good at structuring things so that it's just not out of control? And when things get out of control, you get burnout, or you get low project delivery. You know, there's a lot of boundary going on here. You might want to say, how good am I at setting clear boundaries in all of these domains? And then you have a vendor relationship, which could be partners. And you're telling me the number of vendors you have now has multiplied. When you're saying one vendor, now we have 6, 7 vendors. So this is a multiplication, which means if it's not done well every time, we have a scaling problem. We also have a legacy systems, strategic problem. What do we do with this legacy system? Do we get rid of it? And that may be a complicated process. Or we build on top of it, but in the long run, it creates strong weaknesses. And how do we make decisions about it? So what you have is really, you have really a challenge here on how do we take decisions? You with me? It's fair to say that.
Over here, the legacy system replacement has been in the roadmap for years.
Years.
For more than 10 years since I joined, I have been hearing this. But I think the actual problem is probably at the architecting level. Because we add applications, we add systems, but it just keeps adding.
Not removing.
Not really. The objective is actually stated to replace the legacy with a new application or two.
I agree with the problem. Just to rephrase the problem, it is related to decisions. Okay? So what I feel missing is collaborative decision making. Who decides to add that into the system?
Individual teams. And it's been going on for years.
Yeah. Respective teams, they decide. But no collaborative.
You see what I mean?
Yeah.
One key decision right, is to say go. Whatever plan is on the table, if it is good, if you define your change plan, well, at one point, one decision is made, go. And we know how to phase the legacy system out. This is not happening. We're hearing about these legacy systems for a while, and we look like we're going for kind of a sloppy way to handle it. It's not quite retired. We're building on top of it. And the solution architect is saying, I can build a solution on a building that is not solid, right? Any architect will tell you, get the ground solid, and then I can do architecture. And then if I have architecture, I can bring in solutions. So we are basically at the basics. And behind the basics, thinking, is we're not taking decisions. Therefore, we're getting to the next step. How do people in this environment take decisions?
So the issue of roles. And you bring in the issue of we need to have, you called it a product manager, something like that.
Change manager.
But the way you define the change manager, it should be able to be the interface between IT, the business. And here's this magical superwoman, Superman, that will take all the decisions. Yeah, it would be wonderful. It's like a solution architect, you know? When you have a big mess, people want to hire a solution architect. When this is you. So now that you've been hired, we have a solution in place. It's just taking a lot of time. But he's working on it, right? And you're in serious trouble. So, you know, I don't have to worry about the architect. I don't feel responsible for the delay. All I can do is blame. We've hired the right people, and we even call that guy, change manager, product manager, solution architect. So therefore, we just bought the solution and we bought the success. It has a price, your salary. Now pretty soon people are going to say, how come we still don't have these problems and no solution? Since you're the provider of solution. Be careful, huh? You've been charged to hire a solution magical person. And you also are bringing some issues which touch everything. Time management, but everything is linked. Time management. So in the middle of these things, some of the consequences is you have changing targets.
Okay? So as getting rid of the structure of the legacy system is a strategic decision. I think it's been taken. But you're dealing with tactical decisions that make that this thing is still here, and we're spending money fixing things that will slow us down and doesn't belong to the future. So we'll have to now destroy something we've made bigger. It's kind of what you're saying. And at the beginning, there is no change plan that is credible to phase this thing out. So who's in charge of that? Is this person still around? Well, we can't name this person. So you have a problem of ownership also. Mm-hmm. All of these touch leaderships. Who's the driver? How do we drive? Is this a person? Is this a team? Is this an organization? How do we get it done? In a way that we don't have burnout, we have good relationships with the people we pay to help us. I balance my life, and we transform our dream into reality.